Well, hello everybody, it's John. Welcome on back to the shop as we do another Banggood product review. Today, I think the review might be interesting to both folks that are involved in home shop, as well as some of the ham radio and electronic project people that may follow this channel. Going to be taking a look at an ultrasonic cleaner. Now, this is one that was provided by Banggood for me to do a review on. And you can use an ultrasonic cleaner in many different ways around the shop. If you're working with electronic projects or repairing old radios, a lot of times when you pull the PC board out, tube sockets and so forth, you've got years of accumulation of dust and grime and things that have just settled on the circuit board itself or on the circuit if you don't have a circuit board, if it's an older radio or a piece of electronics. Around the shop, it's very useful in cleaning up old tools, getting dirt, grit, and grime off the different tools. And of course, around the house, you can use it to clean jewelry, cleaning precision parts and so forth. So it's a very wide usable tool that to have in the home shop and also very affordable. Today, we're going to take a look at cleaning some tools, cleaning some jewelry, and just a few things that I found around the shop here that might be appropriate to be cleaned. Now, I have never used an ultrasonic cleaner before, so I'm real anxious to see how this is going to work out and to review this product. But first, let's go to the website and take a look at the specific unit that I'll be reviewing and some of the specs that go along with it. Then we'll come back to the bench, take a look at it, and put this thing to use. This is the page that you'll go to if you click the link below the video, and this is the item that I'm reviewing for this review. It's a stainless steel digital ultrasonic cleaner dental tank heater cleaning equipment. As you can see, it does have a 5-star review, even though it is only one review. However, they have sold 20 units. It's a relatively new item that Banggood has in their stock. If you do notice, the price is $69.06. That's U.S. dollars, and it does come out of China. It took me about 2 weeks to 2.5 weeks to get in this unit for this review. Here are the features that it says on their website. I'm just going to read these verbatim. It does say skid-proof rubber feet, stainless steel case, tank, and lid. Durable stainless steel construction, high resistance to wear, long service life. Industrial controlled chip microcontroller, flexible circuit board control, more secure and stable. Timer display for precise washing time control and easy to operate. Perfect for cleaning long hole, fine draw, and shelter piece of part or workpiece. As you know, sometimes the translation between Chinese and English leaves a little bit to be desired, so I really don't know what that statement right there means. Tap water directly or industrial alcohol or solvent cleaner for higher cleaning requirement. Suitable for glass, jewelry, timepieces, commodities, stationery, and medical articles. And during the cleaning, their ZZ noise is normal. So that's the features that they talk about. Let's go down some specifications. The model specific to this review is a JP-008. Color is silver and black. Material is stainless steel. It does give the size here. I'll go in the inches. It's 6.93 by 4 by 425 by 5 and 0.12. The tank size is approximately 5.91 by 335 by 248. In the video, you'll see I'm using an actual measurement against a ruler that I have that you can actually see this tank and the size in the video that's upcoming. It is 120 volt or 100 to 120 volt, 60 hertz. Several times in the video, I'll also mention that if you do order from Banggood, you'll want to specifically pay attention and make sure you do get one for the voltage for your country. They do have some that are 110 and 220 both. They have some that are 120 only and some that are 220 only. This has an ultrasonic power of 35 watts, a capacity of 0.8 of a liter. The frequency that it operates is 40 kilohertz, and the timer is 0 to 30 minutes, and it does have a US plug model on it. The package that you will receive or that I received also includes the following. The cleaner, of course, and it does come with an adapter according to your country. Mine, as you'll see, came with a 220 adapter also. It does have a cleaning basket, a charger, cleaning lid, screwdriver, glass cloth, and user manual. I did not see the screwdriver, and I'm not real sure what the charger was in there. It did have some other things that may not be listed on this package list here that you'll see in the upcoming video. So that about wraps up what the website reviews. Now let's go on to the bench and see the unit in action. Well, this is the way that the unit arrived. It actually came in a box instead of coming in one of the general black bags that you get products from overseas in. So I'm just going to go ahead and open this up, or at least try to open it up. There it comes. Well, I guess it just comes in a box just like that. So it was shipped in a box with just the tape around it. It looks like it's packed pretty well. It does come with styrofoam and everything. I'm going to go ahead and pull it out. And looks like it does have some adapters here, so that's good. Now, one thing to let you know, there are several ultrasonic cleaners on the Banggood site, and most of them are 220 volts. So if you live in the United States, make sure that you're ordering the correct unit, one that does have 110. And this one right here clearly states on here, the voltage is AC 100 to 120 volts, 60 hertz is the output. It has 35 watts of power, 40 kilohertz is the frequency that it operates from, and it is an 8-liter capacity. It does have a timer on it of 30 minutes. Now, the overall size of it in inches will be approximately just a little shy of 7 inches. It's about 6 7/8, or actually if you want to do overall, it's 6 15/16 inch. The width is 4 3/8 of an inch. The basket size itself, well, let's just talk about this basket size, is 3 1/8 of an inch, and I'm trying to get an internal measurement here. Actually, internally it's 2 3/4. And the internal measurement, or the inside measurement here, is 5 1/4. Of course, I'm rounding that off to the nearest eighth of an inch when I'm doing that. The overall, and let's get the overall depth. The overall depth, as I'm looking at that, is about 2 inches in depth. So it's not an overly large size cleaner. Now, they do have other size cleaners, but be aware, as I said before, that they are a lot of those are 220 volts. Overall height, including the stand here, or the feet, is 5 inches. The overall width, like I say, was 7 inches. I think we covered that before, so it looks like it's pretty good. It does have the cable on it that unplugs both from the unit itself, and it goes into the AC, and as I said before, it does have the adapter plug on it. Now, that is looks like a 250 volt plug. The lid is on it, and the controls are up front right here. We'll take a look at those in just a moment when we start taking a look at using it. But I'm just winging it here. Have not looked at anything here, but it looks like that's where you're going to put the time that you're going to use it with. It does have an on-off switch. This resets, obviously, back. Not sure what L1 and L2 is. I'll take a look at the book in it. It does have a warning here that do not turn this on without any liquid in it, and it is okay to have liquid as it goes. The brand name on this, if it means anything, is Skymen, I guess, ultrasonic cleaner. Model number that they're listing here is 008. It does come, as I said, in addition to the adapter. It does have an instruction sheet here with it. Since I've never used an ultrasonic cleaner, I'm going to go in and at least cursory review. Well, it's not a manual. It's just one sheet of information here. So we'll take a look at that. Also, it did have this little gadget here, which I think I did some reading. I think what that might be for is to lay a watch band or lay jewelry or a bracelet, necklace, and so forth on. And at least that's what I'm thinking. And of course, the basket does come in and out. All right, well, with that thing here, and of course, it's got a lid on it here. Well, I went into the house. I just got back with some tap water. I did check the temperature. This is 100 degrees Fahrenheit water. It's just right straight out of the tap. There's no detergent. I did not put anything in it. And just to try this thing out. Also, I did find out that within this little pamphlet that came with it, it is a fold-out, and it does have the instructions in a little bit more detail. So I did go back and read those. the things that I'm going to be cleaning are these right here. I've got some old jewelry here, one of my wife's class rings. This was from a few years back, if you remember when the nugget ring was in vogue. So this is all gold here, so I thought I'd try doing some gold. This set right here is just some old printer type that I have accumulated. It just spells out John. This was on a printing press at one time, so it's probably still got some printing ink in it. And then from the machine shop, I got the palm grand vise, and I'm going to have to probably do this in two settings. Take one end, put that in the cleaner, take the other end, put that in the cleaner, and we'll see how that is. This has got lots of grease, grime, and grit, and dirt, and so forth on it. Also, I went over to the toolbox and I got a socket. This socket, I would probably say the socket's close to 30 years old. And this came back whenever I was actually doing some farming at one time. And we used to work on all of our farm equipment. So after 25 or 30 years of pretty heavy use, this socket has got lots of grit and grime inside of it. So this is some pretty good stuff to take a struggle with. So we're going to start right off the bat. Setting the timer on 300. I'm assuming that's 300 seconds. And I'm going to start by dropping these pieces of printer's type in here, just dropping them in and giving them some space to actually circulate around a little bit. And of course, these don't move. It's just done by some kind of sound waves and other magic that I totally do not understand. So we're going to put this on and go for 300 seconds and then come back and take a look and see if it did any magic. At this time, you can probably hear the machine running, and there's probably going to be some bubbles if the information online is correct. Now, you may not be able to see it on the camera, but I can actually see little tiny bubbles, very, very small bubbles that are coming up from the printing type itself. So I'm going to let this run for another 278 seconds, then we'll come back and take a look. Okay, at this time, the full 300 seconds has gone by. So I'm going to go ahead and put this down here. Scoot this over a little or up a little bit and get it back in the screen. And just take a look at some of the difference that it may have made. Now, I made a few notes before I did this right here, and as far as some of the cleanliness in it. And now it's been in there 300 seconds, and I can tell that it has cleaned up quite a bit. It did leave a little bit of grease right up in this area right here, and some of that. Now, let me see if I'll take this little scraper here and just see. Actually, that's dried printer's ink. I'm not real sure that's going to come out. It looks like there's not much trash or anything left on it that the scraper itself is getting out. That looks like the only thing left is printer ink on that. I'm going to lay that aside and say that that was qualified success. It did not get the printer's ink off, but it did do a real good job of getting the grit and grime off. Now, the next thing I'm going to try is this half-inch socket. And I'm going to zoom in just a little bit, let you take a look. And as you can see, that's pretty grungy down in there. I don't really know if we're going to be able to get a great deal of that off with this machine or not, but we'll try. Now, this is when I don't know what I'm doing here, and I don't know if it'd be better to put it upside down so the bubbles will come up from the bottom and hit it, or right side up. I'll tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to put it in there upside down like that and see what happens. Now, in this case right here, it did not cover the top of it, and it looks like I'm about up to my max line. And I don't want to put any more water in it. I can turn it back over if I need to. Well, actually, that'll probably be a good sign, because if it didn't go all the way to the top, I'll be able to tell if there's a line halfway up that socket to delineate clean versus non-clean. Once again, 300 seconds. Temperature, again, when I put it in was 100 degrees Fahrenheit. I'm sure the temperature has dropped down. There's no additional detergent or anything. It's just pure tap water. So I'm going to turn it on, 300 seconds. We'll come back and check. By the way, if you're wondering exactly how that sound wave is doing as the noise that it's making, I'm measuring 48 decibels here on my phone with the little app that I have here, which equates to a quiet office or moderate rainfall. Okay, just got through running 300 seconds once again on the same thing. And this time, it came out much cleaner with the little detergent that's in it. Very little cleaning up will go. Now, remember, I had it set for 300 seconds, and it will go up to 900 seconds. So that's with the detergent, and with the exception of a little bit of paint that's inside it, that cleaned up really nicely. So I'm going to lay that aside, and the next thing I'm going to put in are the rings, the jewelry. Let me get this over here and reach around and find it. Put this up, and we'll see how these two rings go. Now, most of that, I think, is tarnish. Not sure exactly what's going to happen on it. We're going to turn it on and see. And just reach down in here and check on this. Well, there may be, I only had 300 seconds. There may be a little bit of cleaning going on. It takes the dirt out. It does that, but it does not take that tarnish off. So if your jewelry is dirty, and this nugget ring has got these little cracks and crevices and so forth in it, you know, these things were pretty popular a few years ago, not more than a few years ago, probably 25 years ago. And so, you know, this one does have some dirt and grime in it. And it did get most of that off. I picked a little bit out. Here's a little crevice right here that still got some left in it. And no telling how long that's, well, I haven't worn this thing in probably 15 years at least. I haven't worn this ring. So for jewelry, I'm going to say it got the crud off, but it did not take the tarnish off. But on the other hand, I'm not expecting it to take the tarnish off either. That would be more of a chemical reaction than it would be anything else. Now let's take the granddaddy test here. I guess I'll call it granddaddy test. What I have here is a palm gram drill press vise, which is not going to fit down in there, but that's okay. What I'm going to do is lay that up, and of course this way there's going to be a line across it that hopefully might be able to tell if we made a difference, and we'll be able to see that line from a cleaning standpoint. So go ahead and crank it up and go ahead and get this thing going. Well, I reset it. I don't need to reset it. Got to come back this way and go. All right. Got the water. This thing must have a heater in it. That's the only thing I can figure out, or the air bubbles themselves cause that water to heat up. I'm not sure. Again, first time I've used one of these things. But that water is actually hotter now than it was when it first started. Or at least it was, well, I don't know. Maybe it's not. I don't know. Don't have a way to test it. Anyway, let's get on with the show. And we're going to cut this on and come back and see what it looks like. Now, I do have water and detergent mixed together in here. All right, we're down to about 16 seconds left on the machine. And as you can see, the water here is pretty dirty. And of course, that was a pretty dirty vise that went in there also. So we've got about 3, 2, 1, and then it kicked off. So let's see what we have here. I'm going to dry it off just a little bit and take a look. Although I don't see a clear line of delineation, when I pull this back, it's obvious, clearly obvious, that all the dirt, grit, and grime from this part right here is off. Now, this is a mistake where I drilled it with a drill, a pretty novice mistake right there, and it did not get down there inside the hole, which begs the question, do I have it upside down or is it better this way? I think with the bubbles coming from the bottom, it just would almost seem to be that the bubbles, the dirty part needs to be facing down. Also right in here, while it's still a little bit of grease and grime on it, there's not a whole lot that I can pull off of that. So I would say that had fairly good success with cleaning that off also. And you can see the water here is pretty dirty. Now I'm going to do one final test here. I've just got this old PC board. Go ahead and take this tab here off and see if it'll fit. Well, it won't, but it'll fit like that. I'm going to put the switches in there. I'm going to put this on for 300 seconds. And we're just going to see what it does to this PC board. Go ahead and get it started. Okay, counting down on the PC board. And I'll say this about PC boards. You might wonder, can you really put that thing in the water like that? Well, of course you can. There's nothing in there that you're going to hurt. Now, there's going to be some components that you don't want to get water on, but for the most part, components today are all sealed up, and you're not going to hurt those a bit in the world. In fact, I've heard of people, I've never done it, but I've actually heard of people throw these PC boards in a dishwasher to get them completely cleaned up. Now, you couldn't really see it too well on here. This board right here did have a little bit of dust and so forth on it. And I will say for the PC board, this thing cleaned it up really well. This may be one of the better examples that of something that I've used so far in getting this. And this came out of an old radio somewhere. I just pull these PC boards out and save them, especially when they have these little switches. As you can see, after the day or the morning has been here, and I've had this thing running off and on for about an hour as I've played with it with very little downtime. I don't know what the duty cycle is on this particular unit, but I mean, it's not even warm at all. And the water has actually stayed fairly warm considering, so either the reaction of the sonic cleaning itself, or this thing has a heater in it, and maybe it does. I can't remember what I said at the beginning of this. It was taped a couple of days ago. But overall, you can see how much dirt was removed from the stuff that I worked on. I'll go back to this vise here just a little bit. And I don't know if the camera's going to pick that up or not, but it really doesn't have anything that's left on it. These two parts here were underwater. Up here was not under the water, and you can see if the camera will focus. That has got still quite a bit of grit, grunge, and so forth on it, where back in here, this has been pretty well cleaned up, as well as the bottom of the unit. The socket set, the socket itself cleaned up relatively well. And the printer type cleaned up well, except for where the printer's ink was. Got some final thoughts, so let's wrap it up. Well, as you can see, that was the little cleaner in action. And again, to go back a little bit, that's the first time I've ever used an ultrasonic cleaner. Don't know a whole lot about them, but it's one thing that I've always wanted here for the shop. So what's the final thoughts on it? Well, if you've got things like that vise that I put in there, probably a carburetor cleaner or a parts cleaner would have cleaned it up much quicker and just as well. Same thing with the socket. A can of carburetor cleaner and a parts cleaner brush, you could have got that done relatively quickly. Now, the other things that we took a look at, the printer's type, you know, that's going to be kind of tricky because, first off, you're dealing with lead. So if you put anything that's harder than the lead, or you're going to be actually scratching that material. Now, you may not be using printer's type, but you could easily be working in your shop or around your home with something that's softer than the brush that you would be cleaning it with. So in that case, the ultrasonic cleaner worked out really well. The jewelry, it really got into the cracks and crevices of the jewelry. It did pull all that dirt out. And I can see it from a perspective that the camera just doesn't pick up sometimes. It did a really good job of pulling the dirt and things out of the cracks and crevices of both the class ring and that old nugget ring that I had. The circuit board was where it really shined because you can't spray carburetor cleaner. You can't use a lot of those caustic chemicals when you're dealing with PC boards and so forth because there's a very high risk that you could easily damage something that's inside one of those components or switches or so forth. And that's where the ultrasonic cleaner, in my opinion, really shines. So if you're cleaning precision instruments or electronic circuits or little areas where you cannot get to, and from what I understand, these ultrasonic bubbles can get up actually inside places and that bubble will explode. And you can go online and research how the ultrasonic cleaner works. I did a little of that. I found it fairly interesting as you go. So would I buy the ultrasonic cleaner? Well, my opinion on that is I don't think that it's a must-have item for your shop. There's other ways to get it done. However, I would put it in the line of things that are pretty nice to have around. It's probably something that you're not going to use all the time, but when it comes time to use it for a very specific purpose, I don't know of anything that's going to do a better job than cleaning than that little ultrasonic cleaner. Again, talking about the duty cycle of it, I kept that thing running often, well, not off and on, but pretty much continuously for an hour with just taking things in and out and making a few comments along on the video. Never got hot, so I think the quality is pretty robust for that particular unit. In closing, if you do order from Banggood, make sure if you're in the United States that you do order one that's specific for the United States. It has 120 volts because some of the things on Banggood are 220. Make sure you differentiate that. Also, in closing, there are some links down below in the description. I get nothing for those links. It just links this specific product right over to Banggood site so that you don't have to do a lot of searching through that. Feel free, as always, to leave comments as long as they're clean, don't have any profanity or off-color language. You're welcome to leave comments that are specific to this particular item right here. So until next time, when we're right back here in the shop, this is John. We'll see you back here from the Upper East Side of Texas. So long, everybody.